In the meantime, Albuquerque, New Mexico is the place of reside of Olivia, our next caller. Hello, Olivia.
Hi. My question is, if the Son of the Son is begotten from the Father, and the Holy Spirit is the love between the Father and the Son, doesn't that mean that the Son and the Holy Spirit are dependent upon the Father for their existence and therefore not God?
Pithily stated question, Olivia.
Olivia, good question and well stated. The way that you stated it, there's one word I would add to all of this that I think would help if you can grasp the word, and that's eternally. The Son is eternally begotten of the Father, and the Holy Spirit proceeds from the Father and the Son. Now, from our perspective, we only know the perspective of time, how things happen within time. And so it would seem that within time, if a Father exists, and then he begets a Son, and then the two of them have such great love for each other that creates somehow or begets a third person, that it would seem as though, well, the Father or the Son and the Holy Spirit are dependent upon the Father. But that's not the understanding of this from a much more highly theological perspective, where we recognize that this happens eternally. It's always happening. It has always happened. There wasn't a time that the Son did not exist. There was not a time that the Holy Spirit did not exist. In fact, they exist outside of time. And that's hard for us to understand, but that word eternity and eternally begotten is very important to really understanding this relationship. And the only way we really distinguish from between the persons of the Trinity is their relationships with each other. So it's good that you understand that Jesus, or that the second person, the Son, is begotten, and the Holy Spirit is often recognized as this great love between the Father and the Son is so great that it's another person. But we have to get away from thinking of it in a sort of succession within time, because it's something that happens eternally. And the Son and the Holy Spirit, there was never a time when they did not exist. Does that help, Olivia?
Yes, it does. Thank you.
Olivia, okay. How old are you?
I'm 13.
13. I can tell you're a very avid reader. Can I recommend a book to you? I think you'd like it. It's called Theology for Beginners by Frank Sheed, Sheed. The chapter there on the Trinity is very comprehensible, and it's deep, but I think you'll really like it because it gets into what Jim is only able to do a limited amount of here on the radio.
Okay.
Good. Thanks, Olivia. God bless you.
Thank